What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. Today, I have four Illustrator functions that you need to know to master color in Adobe Illustrator. I'm kicking off a new series today where we look at lesser known functions in Adobe Illustrator that are really important for specific areas of design. And today we're looking at color. In the next episode, we're going to be looking at functions for typography, so stay tuned for that one. But anyway, see how many of these functions you already know in relation to color in Adobe Illustrator, and see how many of them you learned today. The first function in Illustrator you need to know in relation to color will help you choose awesome color combinations without even having to think. First, locate the eyedropper tool in the toolbar menu, or you can press I on your keyboard. Sample a color you wish to base your color combination around, or simply choose one from the color palette. Then, open up the color guide in Illustrator. Automatically, you're presented with colors that will work well together in a visually appealing manner. However, if we click the drop-down menu, we can access yet more harmonious colors for our design. From here, we can hold down the Shift key and select multiple aspects of our design, and then apply colors from the color guide. This is a great function in Illustrator when choosing colors. The next tip is going to allow room for edits to our colors across the entire design. So I've selected a color group for my design. Before I go ahead and add the color to my work, we could do something pretty neat and helpful. Let's go ahead and open up the swatches menu, and then add a new swatch group like so. Give it a relevant name, and then a new folder will have been created. Hold down the Shift key and select colors you want, and then simply drag and drop them into the new swatch group. Once you've added them, with the swatch group selected, go to Swatch Options. We can check the Global option, which is going to allow us to make changes across the entire design of any specific color. I'm going to go ahead and add a color from my Global Swatch group to some objects. And let's add two different color groups for contrast. Now, because these are global swatches, I can go into the swatch menu, and without anything even selected on my design, I can choose a color and edit it. When I do, the color on the design will change also. You can see how this will be super helpful with a complex design. And the next function on my list will also help you with complicated designs in regard to color. If we have a design with many, many components and colors, how can we select every single object with a specific color? It's quite simple, and I'm going to show you how to do that now. Go ahead and open up the magic wand window, and here you can see some options will pop up. In today's tutorial, we just want to focus on color. Change the tolerance down to 0, and then take the magic wand tool in the toolbar, or you can press Y on your keyboard. If we select an object, we will simultaneously select every other object of that same color across your entire design. You can then, of course, edit everything selected any way you want to. For the last Illustrator function relating to color that you need to know, we're going to look at preset swatches that Illustrator has to offer. There are many categories with a great selection of swatches waiting for you here. So let's, for example, choose Celebration from the menu of colors. I like these pastel colors here, and I want to add them to my design. So grab the magic wand tool as we did before, and then select an object, and then add the color from the swatch menu like so. This is a very quick and easy way to edit your design with preset color swatches. And And as you can see here, this color choice seems to work well for my design. So there was my first episode on lesser known functions in Adobe Illustrator. Leave a comment in the comment section below telling me what you guys thought of today's video. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you found it useful, and if you did, leave a like and share it on social media. Remember to subscribe to Satori Graphics for graphic design content just like this video today. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.